Tell me where to go, tell me what to do. I'll be right there for you. Tell me what to say, no matter if it's true. I'll say it all for you.
I used to be the type of kid that would always think the sky is falling. Why am I so differently wired? Am I a Martian? What kind of twisted experiment am I involved in? Cause I don't belong in this world. That's why I'm scoffing at authority, defiant often. Flying off at the handle at my mom, no dad. So I am non-compliant at home. At school, I'm just shying awkward. And I don't need no goddamn psychologist trying to diagnose why I have all these underlying problems. Thinking he can try and solve them. I'm outside chalking up.
This is a special edition of For Life Podcast, WrestleMania Predictions, for YouTube. First of all, I want to say congratulations to all the Hall of Fame nominees being inducted tonight. That includes Ultimate Warrior, Jake the Snake Roberts, Lita, Paul Bearer, Carlos Colon, Mr. T, and the bad guy, Razor Ramon. So I'm looking forward to seeing all their speeches tonight. My co-host Cheyenne is down there in New Orleans right now as we speak. I think he's online at Access, or trying to get into Access. I tried calling him, but he didn't pick up. But I'm glad he's down there enjoying his time. I was able to enjoy this last year at MetLife Stadium, so I'm glad. I was really disappointed that he couldn't make it last year, so I'm glad that you're down there this year, Cheyenne. Enjoy yourself, bro. I just want to go real quick. I know I'm not sure how we're going to shoot the show this week due to Cheyenne being in New Orleans and all this other stuff. I might do something post-Mania, but right now, my predictions for Mania, we have the pre-show. Los Matadores, Real Americans, Ryback, challenging the Usos for the tag team titles. I'm kind of disappointed this match is on the pre-show just because the Usos and Cesaro, those are three of my favorite guys on the roster right now, and they've worked so hard this past year, and it's a shame they're not going to be on the main show, but I see the Usos retaining. The show's supposed to be opening up with The Shield versus Kane and the Outlaws. I expect that match to be pretty good. Like I said on the show, it's pretty cool that The Shield, they're around my age, so they grew up watching the Outlaws and Kane. So I think it's pretty cool that they're going to be able to enjoy a Mania moment with three guys that they grew up watching. It's pretty cool that these guys are giving the young guys the rub. The Andre the Giant Memorial Battle Royal. This is a tough one, but I'm glad that all these guys are getting a chance to be on the show. A lot of these guys don't really have anything going on in this game because there's so much talent involved in this Rumble that's not getting a chance to shine in Mania, at least in the individual storyline, like Dolph Ziggler, Big E, Sheamus, Christian, Del Rio, Mark Henry, Big Show, all these guys, but at least they're on the card. As far as who I see winning, there's three slots open left. Could be RVD, could be Bad News Barrett, Alexander Rusev. I don't know, but as far as it goes, I can see maybe Big Show winning, just the connection to Andre the Giant. Or my hopefuls would be Dolph Ziggler or Zack Ryder, just wishful thinking. But if not, then I see Alexander Rusev taking it. The next match also on the card is John Cena versus Bray Wyatt. As far as this one goes, I really hope that Bray Wyatt picks up the victory. He needs it a lot more than John Cena does. And John Cena can afford a loss. And I think Bray has been on fire the last couple weeks with his promo work. I thought the segment on Monday night with Cena wearing the sheet mask was awesome. That was probably one of the best things I've seen Cena do in a while. And he didn't have to say a word, which is when Cena's at his best. As far as the streak, Undertaker, Brock Lesnar. This was teased years ago after Brock Lesnar's loss to Cain Velasquez at UFC, where the two had a face-off. They actually want to do it, but they're having this match now. I hope Brock doesn't hurt Taker too bad, but honestly, I don't think anybody thinks the streak is going to end tomorrow night, or that Brock Lesnar's taking the streak, or that anybody's going to take the streak for that night. I think Taker should keep the streak forever. In the main event, we have Daniel Bryan taking on Triple H, and the winner advances to the title match in the main event. I don't see how there can be any other outcome but Daniel Bryan winning this match and the title match against Batista and Randy Orton. Whether they find a way to screw him over, throw Triple H in there, I don't know. If there's rumors of Punk being in New Orleans, that's been circulating a lot. There's been pictures of him with Kofi or him and AJ, but it's not really confirmed that those are in New Orleans or not, but a lot of people do think that he's going to be in New Orleans. as far as it goes, I really don't know what, unless it starts a feud with Daniel Bryan, I really don't see what benefit there would be to having Punk in New Orleans. Other than that, I do expect 75,000 to be champion, yes, at the end of the show tomorrow night. Daniel Bryan is the new champion after chasing the title for the last 6 months in SummerSlam. Even 2 years since his loss to Sheamus in 18 seconds, I've been waiting for this a long time. I've been following Daniel Bryan almost a decade now since Ring of Honor, just like Punk and Seth Rollins, Antonio Cesaro, guys like that. But I'm really looking forward to WrestleMania. I think the build, this might have been one of the best built Manias in the last couple of years. I think WWE has depended a lot on just the Mania name selling. So I'm glad that they've really put their effort into booking this Mania. Not so much Taker and Brock, but Cena and Wyatt and the Triple H Daniel Bryan feud have been built extremely well. So I'm coming at you guys tomorrow night after Mania. Cheyenne, enjoy yourself. All 75,000 of you over there, enjoy yourself. If you're watching on the network, if you're watching at a bar, if you're ordering on pay-per-view, enjoy Mania tomorrow night, guys. I hope you have a great time. Because when you're listening to your podcast or watching, you're listening to your podcast for... live.